Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am back in Anno 2205, continuing right where we left off. I just got done building two brand new mines, each producing their own unique resource, which are both mandatory to help us construct bots. So we're going to place that bot factory down right here. These are necessary to help us build up our space elevator, which is our ultimate goal for this area. And I also wouldn't mind getting a transportation center to increase our productivity. So I'm not sure if that is a mistake or not, because they seem to be really expensive as far as energy goes. I mean, we just got done making even more wind turbines, and now we need 65? I want to try a different type of residence. I want to go straight for the residential complex, because it seems to be bigger. I'm not sure if it's necessary or not, and we are now making constructobots, so that is going to be very possible. So I'm going to put one on each side, and can a regular residence fit in between? It can. That is glorious indeed. They are also ready to be upgraded. I haven't even gotten to look at what Chris Pine's new digs look like yet, much less the upgraded version, so let's zoom in and take a look at all these new buildings. Like I said, I love the detail, love the animation. Of course, you're not going to be playing this zoomed in once you get a gigantic city sprawling the globe. And we're about to catch up on energy and people here very soon. Let's go ahead and upgrade to an even bigger large residence. And hopefully that should take care of our worker needs. And then we just keep having to spam more and more wind turbines to make up for the energy deficit. So rather than continue to just make more and more large residences and small residences, we need to upgrade the ones we already have and start fulfilling their needs. So I'm going to start by upgrading another block. That's going to significantly boost our workforce. And then if we want to, of course, we can start trying to produce some more biopolymers by making some more sunflower farms and some more biopolymer factories. New buildings are available, are they? Let's take a look. We have finally unlocked fruit plantations and vitamin condensers. This is going to allow us to satisfy some of these tier 2 needs. See, they want vitamin drinks, rejuvenators, implants, and security. All we can provide right now, vitamin drinks, and make them at least a little bit more happier than they are right now. So I'm going to produce this on the other side of this wind turbine that I've got here. And I don't know which road to attach it to, actually, or if it even matters. Maybe we can fit double. Aha! I like that! And on the opposite side, do the same thing with the vitamin condensers. These are quite tiny buildings by comparison. So I'm going to start with just one for now. Do we need a second one? Am I going to just run up a huge deficit? Because it seems like I'm just running up a huge deficit. One thing I do appreciate is that Anno 2205 is good about communicating my shortcomings. In this case, we are short on juice. We don't have enough fruit plantations, or in this case, we have too many vitamin condensers. So I'm going to go ahead and demolish one of the two, and that'll go away, because two of these fruit plantations is enough for one vitamin condenser. So learning how many you need for each factory is a big part of the game in learning the supply and demand aspect. Still just a tiny bit short on workforce, but we are really close. So if I upgrade another little sector here to tier 2, it'll kick everybody out, but then it'll bring them right back in. And hopefully soon we also start balancing our credit as well. Again, still trying to figure out the best way to make money at the moment. We finally attracted a population of over 500 people. 672, actually, which is enough to get us a tidal power station. We have 522 operators. That means people working in these operator facilities. So now I can make this huge energy producer at a coastal spot. So this, again, has pre-designated locations that you must build into. Of course, it must connect up to a road. So this seems to be the closest and thus most efficient. So we're going to build a road and cannot actually sneak a road in right here. So we're going to have to go around this other power station, which is fine. Hey, I can hold right mouse button. Are you dizzy yet? Probably. Short on workers, so I'm just going to continue to upgrade each one of these quadrants as we get enough biopolymers to allow for it. So that is one of the major resources in the game. And I've gone to make steps towards producing even more. I've added a second sunflower farm, which hopefully is enough to keep workforce missing. Okay, that's the only thing keeping us from 100% is getting some more people in here. And one of these days, I will have all positive numbers, but it is not this day. For this day, we are losing a ton of credits right now. Here's where things start to get a bit difficult for me to juggle. We have a shortage of food and a small shortage of water. But of course, building new facilities is going to run us even further into debt. And making money is where I'm struggling the most. I'm playing on the medium difficulty, which is supposed to be challenging if that matters to you. There is an easier mode that provides more revenue from each employee and residence, but we are not playing there. So I'm going to go ahead and queue up another rice farm. We've got two already, so we're going to add a third. And a new plant on the coast somewhere. There's a perfect spot right here. We only need to connect a road up to it. And that is perfect. But how much energy is that consuming? Well, the good news is that the last energy producer that we made, which I think is over here, yes, the tidal power station is producing so much, but it's also costing us 480 to maintain. So I think that's where most of our money is being sucked up compared to an individual wind farm has only 60. Okay, so this is just nuts by comparison. That's where most of my money is. See, we have just an overabundance of energy. So as I continue making new facilities and getting new residents, that's going to start balancing and evening out a lot more. I've also doubled up on our biopolymer factories. So we've got even more to upgrade with, which is good. I'm going to go ahead and take advantage of that now. Some of our new neighborhoods are in need of upgrades. We can only upgrade so much. For the time being, our corporation level up is going. We're earning some money for leveling up. Got a pretty good chunk just for that. And we're getting close to our marker for 1,000 population. In fact, we're almost at 1,000. We just need 1,000 operators. Super residence park going in. So many new housing structures. One complaint I do have. I don't mind the fact that I'm building tons and tons of the same building, but I do mind that I'm building tons and tons of the same building. Does that make sense? Like, I don't mind that these are all the same residents, but I mind that they're literally identical models. It's even more noticeable. Also, please, Chris Pine, leave me alone. I'm trying to click off of you. I can't quit you. I don't like that it's the same building. I don't mind that it's, you know, same in name, but the fact that it's the same picture really irks me for some reason. When you're zoomed out, of course, once your city gets bigger, you're not gonna really notice that as much. But if I do now. I notice it now. And I feel like I can't unsee it. Guess what? After all of those new large residences, we have a ton of people. Ton of people, ton of energy, and most importantly, positive credit balance. So I'm not gonna touch anything else, and we're gonna go check out the spaceport, which is somewhere over here. And we need to build this up to presumably connect it to the moon. That's what I assume. 25 Constructobots, please. I got almost three times that, bud. And this is where John Rafferty normally tells us about what he's doing. But I don't want to listen to you, John Rafferty, because you are under attack by pirates. And I'm gonna have to go rescue you. And yes, I have done this before because I had to prepare so I could at least tell you the basics of Anno 2205. So I hope I've gotten as much right as I've talked about, because if not, I'm gonna be really embarrassed. And we're gonna skip on over to actually helping out Mr. Rafferty here. Switching over to the strategy map, which you can also, I think, do by hitting the space bar, we get a better global view. We've already taken a look at this global view, but here we've got our first new clickable button. Weirdly, Anno 2205, like its predecessors, I assume, has combat. So if you don't mind taking a little break from building up your city, you can dive into a little bit of aqua combat. We're gonna accept this mission and jump on into it. I do appreciate the way that it loads each new location. It's actually loading in the mission right now, but you can also do other things. And in fact, Cape Ambar is still producing money for us. So it is not paused. It is still accruing money and resources in real time, which I think is cool, even while we take on this intervention mission. So suddenly, the building takes a back seat to more of a real-time strategy style of game. But from what I've been able to experience so far, it is not particularly deep. It's a bit arcadey. And you know what? I don't think it needs to have a super in-depth real-time strategy element to it, but this introductory mission is particularly snooze-worthy. I don't think it's a bad idea to have to build up your own fleet, but these are just ships that were given to me by the mission, and it's just kind of giving us an idea of what we're going to be aware of. So As time goes on, you do need to build up your own fleet to maintain your military prowess. But for now, we can just kind of steamroll this mission. Right-clicking to pick up things like Missile Barrage, which act as special abilities, and Fuel, which is going to be stored in this meter here at the center bottom of the UI. And we're just going to stand back and watch as these ships run into the flashing red explosive devices, blowing everyone sky high. Luckily, John Rafferty's here in his super cruiser, which is going to be healing us with that magical green beam. So we will never die, literally never die. So I'm just going to cruise around the map, right-clicking on everything until it blows up, picking up the occasional resource along the way, and assignments sometimes. So like, say I can go over here and left-click on this. He wants valuable ores, and he'll give us some iridium and combat experience, which we can use back in the building scenario. So it's going to give you resources that you can put towards other structures and buildings. So I don't even know if we have any of what he wants, or if we can even get any of it. But either way, something a little bit different. A slight change of pace. I think it's cool that it's here, and I'm hoping it gets more in-depth the further I go. But like I said, this introductory mission, I could have done without. I would have rather just built up my own ships instead of getting these basically for free. We have done it. We have completed the space elevator. I didn't want to have the whole 20-minute combat scenario play out in the video. This is the result. We headed back to Cape Ambar, took the resources from the convoy that we were defending in the mission, and we have built this wondrous space beauty for all of mankind to enjoy and marvel at. But back on the planet's surface, we have a new objective from Sam Beaumont. These guys talk your ear off for most of the game. Again, I do have these muted, so all the people you've seen so far do have dialogue to talk to you about. We're going to go to a new region now by opening the strategy map and entering the Arctic sector. This is the first experience that I'm going to have with relaying two unique locations. So eventually we'll be able to maybe trade between all of these diverse areas. First, we have to choose a starting sector. Each time you make a new colony, you have to choose where you want to begin. Of course, eventually I assume you can build across the whole map if you so choose. I am going to go with something a little bit different. Do we want ornamentals, rare materials, or logistics? This one looks a little bit more challenging since it has fewer building sites, so we're going to jump on in over on this sector first. Here is our first look at our new Arctic paradise. I do really enjoy the way that Anno 2205 looks. Visually, it is, dare I say, a feast. It's very pleasing to the eyes, okay? I'm not trying to get a little bit too overdramatic here. I like the way it looks. It's not distracting. It has enough detail to keep me satisfied. And that's all I really need. So we're going to start out with a very simple command ship. We have nothing here, guys. No city, no nothing. Just a spaceport, a command ship, and some local wildlife to look at as we swim on by. We have to claim an island. What island do we want to go to first? Probably not the tiny dinky one over on this side. What is this already pre-built here? A trader! Interesting! I have not had the opportunity to even attempt to dabble in trading yet. We have an island on the western portion, lots of open, flat area to build. I like that. Seems to be the same on both sides. I want to go left first. So we're going to head to the port. You can see a wireframe indicating where your command center can be built up. But in order to, of course, construct it, you need to have a certain amount of resources. So if I click claim area, it will consume the necessary resources and freeze the game. All right, well, give it a few seconds to recuperate. We now have our huge Arctic base with a lot of new buildings to work with. Do we get completely new construction options depending on where we go? We do! Arctic dwellings, polar roads. Okay, some of these are just duplicates, but we also have brand new resources. Fishing, compression chambers, new types of mines. That's pretty sweet. Anyways, guys, I hope you have enjoyed this second video on Anno 2205 as we launch into a brand new sector with its own set of rules and challenges to overcome. If you want to see even more, let me know what you think down in the comments below. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.